catastrophe will be his legacy to thousands of people with serious illness who still want to work. When such a BBC News. As far as far as I
We'll be with you shortly, but first of all, catch up on the news travel no matter where you are this morning. Hello, good morning. More details on a major rail upgrade will be given in York later by the Transport Secretary. Most signalling is still based on traffic lights, but the government wants to use new digital technology to control trains, aiming to make them faster and safer. The Trans Pennine route is to be the first digitally controlled intercity railway.
Passenger numbers have doubled, the railways are busting at the seams, and we're now spending £20 billion over the next 5 years to try and create a more reliable railway. And what I'm saying today is digital technology is going to be at the heart of that, making sure that our railway is ready to maximise the potential of digital and make it more reliable for passengers.
Charities on the Lincolnshire coast say there's been a dramatic increase in the number of people homeless or needing help from food banks. Skegness is in the top 20% of most deprived areas in the UK. The Salvation Army's shelter in the town, which has 50 beds for those in need, says it's seeing people from all backgrounds. A ban on selling products relating to smoking at a new shopping complex has sparked a row between traders and Barnsley Council. Things like lighters and rolling papers won't be allowed on stalls at the glassworks on public health grounds. But it's emerged the council has money tied up in tobacco companies through its pension funds.
I think they're utterly hypocritical. And what I think they need to do is let me and my colleagues carry on running as businesses until they've drawn every last pound coin out of the global tobacco industry. And then they're leading by example.
Well, Barnsley Council says it's aware of the investment and will explore the issue further. Now, the Peacock Carnival could be making a comeback. It was last held in 2016, but then cancelled because North East Lincolnshire Council didn't find anybody to run it. Now a group has come forward to put on a parade next year, after first throwing a carnival midsummer. Getting more children from a South Asian background into cricket will be discussed when the England Cricket Board visits Bradford today. It's planning to create 20 urban cricket centres around the UK, teach more sessions in primary schools, and award bursaries to talented young players. And Huddersfield Town's place in the Premier League is secure for another season. This was the scene as fans celebrated outside Stamford Bridge last night. The 1-1 draw at Chelsea was enough to keep the Terriers up.
Owen, good morning.
Sunlight gone on the headline, always nice to see one of those, and we are going to see plenty of that today. A chilly start, mostly dry with sunny spells. Let's put some detail on that map. Now, we may just get the odd scattered shower today, but yes, dry weather is kind of what we're going for as far as the emphasis is concerned. And yes, those temperatures, we're talking 14 or 15 Celsius. Maybe we could see a 16 somewhere from the Humber down towards the Wash. Overnight, well, very similar, really. It's going to be dry, other than the odd scattered shower, some clear skies overhead, and temperatures probably get down to about 4 or 5 Celsius. We could see the odd mist of fog patch again tomorrow morning, but, you know, the outlook doesn't look too bad. I'll keep you posted on Twitter. See you soon.
And that is the latest from us for now. So I'll hand you back to Charlie and Neville.